Hi, I'm Diego Graffi from Piaggio India, and thanks to Autocar for asking me to share my experience. I'm missing a lot of things actually of my normal working day in office, starting from the moment in which I leave my place and I jump on my car and I drive to reach my office, but luckily it's quite nearby. I love the sensation that I feel when I enter office among the first one, and I have that time for myself to plan and to review the tasks that they have to complete for the day and for the week. I love the long queue of meetings that happen afterwards with the team, with customers, with vendors, with dealers, with media. Not only Pune, but also outside Pune, obviously, I'm traveling quite a lot because I love the opportunity that come out of this personal interaction with people, because I consider them a big stimulus for my creativity and to see if new business ideas can come out. And last but not least, I love the sensation that I feel when I take a walk around our Baramati plant and when I see the ordinated cows with which vehicles are coming out of the assembly line to be loaded on truck and dispatched to all corners of India. There are definitely good things of being home in this period, some good things. One above the others is that, for example, I can now plan my training session. I'm quite a fitness and gym maniac, actually, more effectively and positively at normal timing, since when I'm at work, usually I'm forced to train at impossible timing, early in the morning, very early in the morning, or very late in the evening. But then also I like the opportunity that I have to do a lot of review with team to plan and to replan activities for the next future and to see if new business opportunities can be identified. Actually, I consider somehow this period a sort of pit stop in my life, during which I'm reviewing a lot of things, both from personal and professional point of view. And for example, I have the opportunity to spend more time in video call with my family, my wife and two kids, but sadly as me are stuck in Italy during lockdown period that is imposed there as well. Well, I have to say that since when I shifted to this place nearly 1 year ago in Pune, I never had really the opportunity to enjoy time at home in the conventional manner. Now I have more time to do that. For example, I'm setting a lot of things that were pending since long time. And then, actually, I'm not really a home kind of man. I do not like cooking, that kind of stuff. So sometimes I really feel like being a sort of tiger in a cage. But at the same time, I'm a quite positive and optimistic person. So, as said, I'm taking time to review things, both from personal and professional point of view. And to say that I read really everything, books, but not only. I spend a lot of time in reading news on the web, not only obviously on the coronavirus situation on a global base, but also, for example, reading a lot of opinions from experts that are trying to predict what will be the business evolution after, during COVID and after COVID, not only in India, but also on a global base. Another good thing is, for example, that I have more time for professional training. Actually, a very interesting session last week, 3 days, along with my team on design thinking approach, and we learn how some multinational global companies have been applied this approach to earn competitivity and to earn business opportunities in business scenario very, very uncertain and really fast changing as the one that most probably is in front of us. My normal days, my working day usually is very normal in the sense that I wake up very early in the morning between 6 and 6:30. I do my training. Then my working day starts, a lot of video conference meetings with the team, with customers, with dealers, with media. Then lunchtime, I take a break, some more training, and then back to work when I prepare usually the session that we have in the evening with the rest of Piaggio team all across the world, since all of us, obviously, we are very interested to share which are the business perspective in every country of the world in a post-COVID scenario. I would not say that the work from home modality is the most suitable one for a manufacturing company like us. Anyway, I see some advantages. For example, the time that you have after each meeting to debrief with yourself, with the rest of the team. And then some indirect advantages are there. Definitely, for example, I like to listen to loud music when working, when do not have meetings, obviously, because it helps my concentration and I can address quite informal. While instead, when I'm working in office, I have to be more formal. So I save a lot of time actually. There is an opportunity for sure, maybe not directly related to the work from home situation, but also from the, how to say, overall economic and business scenario that is going to happen after lockdown will be lifted in India, but also in other countries of the world. So for sure, companies, not only automotive ones, will have to spend a lot of times during this period, but also after, to look quite deeply inside themselves and to review completely their internal processes, most probably their organization, their way to interact to external customer, to dealers, and whatever it is. So I think that this is something, there is a need that every company will have to go through in the next period. From that point of view, I have to say that the training course that we had on design thinking, I think that has helped us to identify a lot of areas of weaknesses that were hidden, and so we were not even aware of, and so we have already taken some correction afterwards. For example, one thing that I'm sure we have been missing as a company here, at least here in India, is the opportunity coming from digitalization. Not only applied to internal business processes, but also in terms of a new way of interacting with external customer, for three-wheeler, two-wheeler, and whatever it is. I think that off-site opportunity, though maybe not in a forced manner like this one, definitely can be very helpful for business. We had been applying that principle quite often already in the past, in which we had a lot of opportunities in which I'm taking my team out of office for a couple of days in a faraway place, in which we spend time to review plans and replan for the next future. So I think that we will keep on doing that, maybe more often and more frequently. I think that I'm quite a lucky man in the sense that my team is a traditionally self-motivated one and do not need a lot of motivation from my side, in the sense that it is a very fresh team, quite young in age and very well attached to the Italian brands that we are representing here in India. So I do not feel really the need of keeping them motivated. I think that the need that I feel is to transmit them some direction and guidelines for the future, because we are going to play definitely in a very complex, complicated, and uncertain scenario. And I am also convinced that in the background of the mindset of everybody, still some fear will keep on being there. And so I think that our role, our duty as managers of this company is to transmit to our team a lot of positivity, trust in the future, to keep them engaged and to keep them, how to say, on the business every day. Oh, it's a very complicated question in the sense that saying now how much it will take in India or wherever else in the world to come back to normalcy of business is quite difficult and complex. I think that not even a magician crystal ball to predict future will help. Actually, as I said, I'm reviewing a lot of opinion coming from experts in business, but not only in business. And you can range from a very different scenario. Somebody will say that it will take 12 to 24 months for business in India and across the world, mainly automotive business, to come back to a sort of normalcy. Some other one are more optimistic, and they say that if we are able to contain virus spread in a post-lockdown scenario, maybe in 6 to 12 months we will come back to normalcy. My expectation or hope is that if economies and countries all around the world are capable to cooperate positively, to contain virus without the need of any other forced lockdown, we can positively forecast and foresee that we will see some coming back of normal business before the end of this year. In terms of transition to Barra 6, we are actually very well placed in the sense that we completed transition for all our two-wheeler business far above the deadline before the end of 2019, and I think that 95% of our three-wheeler product gamma range is already completed in terms of transition. And now all our stock in the network for both business is full Barra 6 compliant. I think that quite nil we have stock, residual stock of Barra 4. This because we took the matter very, how to say, in a very, how to say, proactive and how to say, anticipated manner, and we managed to complete the transition for most of the version before the end of 2019. So we are ready quite well in advance. Focus on the team now in this period is mainly, how to say, on maintaining the cash flow position of the company in a positive trend, and at the same time we are looking for efficiency in terms of operating expenses to maintain our profitability. Definitely, having had nearly one half and a month, and it will be 1 month and a half of full stop of operation of revenues, of production, of sales, of incoming. But at the same time, we had to pay fixed costs, we had to pay rent, salaries of people, energy cost, and whatever it is. So definitely, I think that cash flow is a challenge not only for us, but for every other company, not only in India, but also across the world. I have to say that luckily, Piaggio India, but as a whole, is a very healthy company and financially sound. So we have been able to manage this period. Definitely with difficulties, but without much of anxiety. What we need to recover is very easy to say. If lockdown will be lifted after 3rd of May, as expected, we'll have to recover down the line and nearly one and a half months of operation. And so we have the rest of the year to do that. And obviously, a conventional approach to business will be most probably not enough. We'll have to maintain our focus and concentration on cash flow and profitability, on a good growth path, and definitely seeking as much as possible efficiencies in terms of operating expenses, as I was saying. So this is, I think, need for us, but I think is common need for everybody in India and all across the world. Focus will be from two points of view. Focus from personal point of view to come back a sort of normalcy of social life quite soon and have a possibility also to see my family that for various reasons I've not been able to do in the last 3 to 4 months. And then from professional point of view, obviously, as I was saying, concentrating and focus on maintaining company on the growth curve on which it has been in the last 3 years since when I came here as a CEO. I cannot say that I really have any particular expectation from the Indian government. One thing that I need to say that I think that decision taken nearly 1 month ago to impose lockdown was very needed one. Otherwise, I'm sure that consequences for Indian population would have been definitely disastrous. So the bill that India economy and global economy will have to pay in the next future for that will be definitely very, very high. But we are supporting that decision 100%, and for example, we are taking a lot of initiative to help and support hospital in Pune and Baramati area, providing them contribution to have enough medical supplies to fight this terrible virus and creation, for example, of isolation ward, specially dedicated to treat COVID-19 patients. And moreover, we are providing regularly food rations and essentials to migrant workers that are stuck in Baramati plant, where in the Baramati area where our plant is. Expectation for future, I would not say that again. I have any particular expectation. I think that is enough if we will be able to restart soon doing business production, and our supply chain can restart, and our dealer can reopen. And then I think that rest will only up to us to turn things positively.